வணக்கம், வந்தனம், சுஸ்வாகதம், நமஸ்தே, நமஸ்கார். இன்னைக்கு நம்ம எபிசோட் ரே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஹேவ் அபவுட் வேர்ல்ட் ஹார்ட் டே. 29 செப்டம்பர் வந்து நம்ம ஹார்ட் டே. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ ஸ்பெஷல் எபிசோட் வேர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டாக் அபவுட் சிம்பிள் திங்ஸ் ஆன் ஹவு டு கீப் யுவர் ஹார்ட் ஹெல்தி. So like I said, namma vandu we have to put our heart as a priority, right? And I have with us Dr. Dharani, who has been guiding us through how to have healthy lifestyle through diets, right? Which is also very important. And then Dr. Dharani, how important is health and why should we put health, a heart, healthy heart as a priority?
Health is always the first priority. Okay. Yeah. And why? Because health is wealth in the Kalthli song. They did not, you know, no other wealth is equal to health.
Correct.
You may have pots of money, but if your health is gone, there's no point. You can't enjoy it in any way.
Absolutely.
But to give it to the hospitals.
Right.
And is that a way to live? Is a big question mark. Right. So, health irukkanum. Idu romba romba mukkiyam. Adhile, namba odambila paatha, you can be brain dead. You can have a stroke. Kai thooka mudiyada irukkalam, kaala thooka mudiyada irukkalam. But when do they say the person is gone? It is when your heart stops working. So heart ingarade is a pumping machine actually. And adu eppa aarambikkirathu? Namba amma vayathukulla irukkirathiye 3rd maasathukku meleye adu kaadila vilarudhu. Adukku munnadiye adu aarambichudrathu. ஸோ ஒரு குழந்தை ஒரு தாய் வந்து ஒரு செக்கப்புக்கு போனா பிரெக்னென்ட்னா அந்த ஒரு காதில் அந்த குழந்தையோட அந்த ஹார்ட்டை கேட்டா ஃபீட்டல் ஹார்ட்டா ஒரு பிரசன்னம், ஒரு சந்தோஷம், ரைட்? த டாக்டர் ஆல்சோ டுடே தே புட் இட் ஆன் அ ஸ்பீக்கர் அண்ட் ஷோ இட் டு எவ்ரிபடி ஹூஸ் தேர் அண்ட் ஸோ யூ நோ எவ்ரிபடி வாவ் வீ லிஸ்னிங் டு த ஹார்ட் ஆஃப் த டு பி பார்ன் பேபி அண்ட் ஹவு அதர் 6 months டு கோ. You know, so from then on till the last second of our life, our heart has to beat. And why does it beat that way? If you take the heart cycle, it takes a rest in the every 1.5-2 minutes that it goes. And that's why it's able to go that many years. If we see people who are 103, 106, 99, 98, right? So that many years that heart is pumping even before the child was born. So heart health is very, very, every overall health is important. But heart health, because this is what pumps your blood throughout your body. And engaya the seriya blood pogalena, you're going to be in trouble.
So has, so leaving aside, nama usually nenikirom illaya that we should have a healthy lifestyle or in the madri, but somehow enakku ipo thonudhu COVID-19 has made it imperative to adopt healthy lifestyle, right? How should we have a healthy lifestyle, healthy heart abindrathu enoda kelvi, right? So idu vandu only because of COVID nama indha mari situation la irukkanuma illa naturally idu irukkanuma to have a healthy heart?
Healthy heart has to be natural. And what do I do? I can do a lifestyle which is a healthy heart lifestyle.
Right.
That is why exercise na enna solra cardio exercise pannunga.
Absolutely.
Alternate days.
Yes.
Cardio na heart ku exercise pannunga. Unga pulse nanna mele poi keela irangatum. And the heart adha eduthukatum. Whereas if you are a heart patient, they'll say, irunga irunga. Inda pulse ku mele please don't go. Make sure you don't raise your pulse above a particular point. Ippo if you go to Rajasthan, you want to go up the fort, or you go to Machu Picchu, you have to climb up, or you're climbing up the Himalayas or in Himachal Pradesh. If you are a heart patient, enna solva illa neenga paathu poongale neenga plains la irna nalladhu illaya.
Yes,
you know, so that important is a heart health.
Okay.
And how can we maintain it? By exercise, right? Regular exercise.
Okay.
Research tells us only 2 people out of 100 people really exercise the way they should.
Oh, okay.
We see marathon runners, we see cyclists, we see I mean, I feel because I've been exercising for many, many years and I live close to the beach.
Okay.
So I go to the beach very often and I cycle. Now I cycle, before I used to run, whatever. So the thing that I feel a lot of people are coming, you know. முன்னாடி இருந்ததுக்கு இப்போ நிறைய பேர் வரா, ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமா இருக்கு. பட் ரிசர்ச்னு பார்த்தா ரெண்டு பேர் தான் 100 பேர், விச் இஸ் நாட் அ கிரேட் திங். எனக்கு மேரத்தான் நான் ஓட போறேன், அதனால நான் 3 மாசம் ஓடினா அதுக்கப்புறம் நான் இட்ஸ் ஓகே, இட் டசன்ட் மேட்டர். தட் ஷுட் நாட் பி தி ஆட்டிட்யூட். யுவர் ஹார்ட் டசன்ட் ஃபெயில் யூ இல்லையா, இட் கீப்ஸ் பீட்டிங். கான்ட் வி கிவ் இட் தட் ஒன் ஹாஃப் அன் ஹவர் டு 45 மினிட்ஸ் அ டே டு ஹெல்ப் இட் மெயின்டைன் தட் இல்லையா? அது கெட்டு போனாதான் நான் எக்ஸசைஸ் பண்ணுவேனா? தேவை கிடையாது. சோ எக்ஸசைஸ் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். செகண்ட் இஸ் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ். Like even yesterday I saw an article where a very old person was living with a dog, only 2 people. The dog died in that shock, this man died. Puriyadha? So shock can create, so shock and stress. Stress of something very happy, stress of something very sad, both can affect you very deeply. That is why to a heart patient we say, go slow, talk to them, keep your adrenaline low and tell them very slowly after finding out, you know, how are you feeling? What is this? So whether you say a good thing or a bad thing, wait, let them calm down. Let them first adjust that you are there. Then you tell them slowly. That is very important because a shock can create a cardiac arrest. So if a heart in sonna, heart disease kanam pono na, பல விதம் இருக்குமா? So when I come to diet of heart, it's not a single diet. If I have hypertension, we are the global cardiac capital of the world, India. புரியுதா? இதெல்லாம் ஒன்றும் காலர் சப்பே கிடையாது. எனக்கு காலர் கிடையாது, பட் காலர் சப்பே கிடையாது. புரியுதா? பிகாஸ் வை? ஹைப்பர்டென்ஷன் இஸ் வெரி ஹை. ஹைப்பர்டென்ஷன்னால blood vessels will get affected and then other effect ana heart effect. Minne kaalathile 50 vayas nee master health checkup paakra, please lipid profile paathru appdin sonna. Ipa 25 vayas yaro enak moochu vida mudiyala na nera icu, because the stress levels are so high, not only because of COVID, much before that, because people are taking life too seriously. 16 மணி நேரம், 18 மணி நேரம் ஒர்க்கிங் ஃபார் வாட்? ஃபார் ஷார்டனிங் யுவர் லைஃப்? இஸ் இட் வர்த் இட்? ஹவு மச் எவர் யூ ஆர் எர்னிங், ரைட்? யூ நீட் டு ஹேவ் அ பேலன்ஸ் இன் லைஃப். எக்ஸசைஸ் பண்ணணும், டி ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் பண்ணணும், டயட் சாப்பிடணும். ஸோ ஐ கம் பேக் டு த டிஃபரெண்ட் டயட்ஸ் வைல் யூ கீப் ஆஸ்கிங் மீ, பிகாஸ் ஐ திங்க் ஐ அம் டாக்கிங் டூ லாங்.
நோ, ஆக்சுவலி ஐ ரியலி வாண்ட் டு ஆஸ்க் திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் அண்ட் ஐ திங்க் இன் ஆர் சேனல் இட்செல்ஃப் வி ஹேவ் மூவ்ட் அவே ஃப்ரம் எனி கோவிட் ரிலேட்டட் ஸ்டஃப் பிகாஸ் ஐ திங்க் இட்ஸ் done a lot of times, right? But this is a very important question. We are seeing a lot of cardiac deaths due to COVID, right? So is it because of the unknown virus and how it performs and all of that, or is it also because of the stress?
It can be multiple reasons. We need a lot of research before we comment on all this, because COVID vandu lung affect pannum, so breathing e affect aagum,
right?
Then we don't even know where all it's affected, because one research says blood clots. Blood clots not direct to heart, not only heart, brain, anywhere. So one single clot, if it clots any of the major vessels, either you get a stroke or you're done. The ulagathile tata. So if there's something which is clotting my blood, I don't know where all harm it can create. So we need a lot more data to be analyzed seriously, and only after 4-5 years namukku actually theriyum ena ipo iduvo aduvo apdi irukalam epdi irukalam avula dhaan varudhu, because you can't blame them. People are firefighting to save lives at this time. Maybe this na solla mudiyume vaya, they can't pinpoint and say this happened and the virus is mutating. So I mean, where do you keep a cope of, okay, can I save 20 lives, 100 lives, as many lives today? Wonderful. That's all I have to do.
Right. Yeah. So is it possible, right? Is it possible to have a healthy life by keeping a check on the nutrition and healthy heart by keeping a check on your diet?
Definitely. See, the four pillars of life are what we spoke, de-stressing, exercise, diet, and medication if you require. These are the four pillars of life. So we won't go into medication because I'm not an expert. But if you need to take any medication, do take it. That's all I will say. Coming back to diet, as I was trying to tell you, there are different types of heart disease. So blood pressure na sodium akara. Today, if I make a soup at home from fresh vegetables with a little salt, one cup of soup, 200 ml, is 2 milligrams of salt. If I buy a soup powder and I make a soup and I take the same cup of soup, it's 20 milligrams sodium. This is the jump when you don't want to cook yourself and you buy in things or you use some semi-cooked stuff to make your stuff. This is what the youngsters of this country do not understand. Now, why? Because in order soup, when I make it at home, it's only salt, nothing else that I add. So salt is the major source of sodium, but there are thousands of foods with a lot of sodium in our food. Okay. Then comes, when I put it from the package, there's a taste enhancer, which is sodium based. There's a stabilizer, which is sodium based. And so also the salt that I add. So with all of this, it goes up 10 times. So I have this powdered soup maybe once a month, maybe once in 2 months, not a problem. Every soup I take is that, or every food I take is that, you're in trouble. And that is what is happening today. That's what I meant when I said, you're working 16 hours, you don't have time to sleep, you don't have time to de-stress, you don't have time to cook food for yourself. If you employ somebody to cook, they're not bothered about your salt or your oil. That's the next one in the diet. How much oil should I use? 15 ml, 15 ml, 15, 1, 1, 1, 3 fives.
So right. Can any type of oil or do the or only ginger oil?
That's what I'm coming to. 10 ml of traditional oil from okay. North India, mustard. From South India, coconut or gingerly or yellu, sesame oil or groundnut oil, whichever you are used to. 5 ml can come from sunflower, rice bran. Out of the 10 ml you are used to ghee, use 5 ml of ghee, 5 ml of traditional oil, and 5 ml of the other types of oil. Now you can afford olive oil, go with it, no problem. You can't afford it, don't get a heart attack and say, oh, I can't afford olive oil. That's not needed, right? If you see the current generation of people who are 90 plus, they've not touched olive oil. They've not touched because they've never lived in their time. Olive oil was not available in our country.
I agree.
And they've never, if you tell them to eat, they'll say, illa, nalla ne kolva. Right? So, we can live healthily because the way they lived was de-stress. I'll tell you an example. When my mother-in-law, when I was running behind, I have two girls. When I'm teaching them, you know, when they're in class 3, class 4, please finish this today. This kind of thing. Then you can go play. 10 minutes you study. Then you can go play. She'll say, why are you doing this? I am a 6th standard pass. I have 5 children. One is a PhD. One is a CA. One is an engineer. One is a teacher. What did I do? I fed them well. I de-stressed them. They learned on their own. Everybody will tell, no, no, no. Today the syllabus is high, you know, peer pressure, we are crazy. How do you think a rickshaw man's son passes joint entrance exam in IIT? Think about it. The poor guy is running, cycling to get his ends meet. But don't you see somebody topping the CA, somebody stopping 12th standard? Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying don't teach. I'm saying don't overdo it. So don't stress yourself. Stress the children. Today, children are going into depression because of the stress, and stress is a major cause. Okay. So coming to the lipids and the oils, and why I said de-stress is very important again and again, because it's related to heart disease. Okay. Then next comes in the diet is, we spoke about sodium, we spoke about oils. Now we come to, if I buy something, it's full of oil and maida, only two things. And the type of oil is not the healthy oil. Your biscuits are full of palm oil, which you don't buy at home. Your puffs are made of vanaspati oil, which you don't buy at home. But you are ready to grab it and eat it. And you heat it in your microwave to make it, you know, hot. You know, it needs to be, you know, far, you know, nice, hot. Every time you reheat your food, you're creating trans fats in your food. And trans fats is not good for you. Trans fats are the fats which create cardiac disease. So there are various things we are doing wrong. It's not a particular way of cooking. It is reheating and quick cooking, quick heat to high temperatures. These are dangerous. It changes the type of fat to the wrong type of fat. The fat might have been butter, but no puff is made with butter. Everything is made with vanaspati oil. Okay, but it was made with butter originally. Today, with the expense of butter, I don't think any of the commercial fellows are going to use butter. Right? So these are the problem. Okay, again coming back. If I eat two curry biscuits once a week, perfectly all right. Or a small little puff once a week, knowing that it's not good for me, it's fine. But every day, I know so many people, at 11 o'clock, they're outside drinking something called soup. They think it's healthy, but it's not the real soup. So the main issue is buying in food, buying in packets which are already made, or buying in packets which will help you cook fast. These are the troublemakers.
Absolutely. I think what you're saying is 100% right, because the cardiac issues, the age group, I think as far as I have read, is in the 30s and 40s more than what is in comparison with the 80s or 90s people, right? I'm sure you, your generation or my parents' generation have lived a healthier life, and they've worked much harder than we have, right? So we have the luxuries of a car or a bike or all that, right? But I remember our parents used to travel in the chartered buses or regular buses, walk all the way, come back home late night, still cook at home and eat. There was never Swiggy or a Dunzo or a Zomato, all these options, right? But here, in spite of having a cook or in spite of having all the domestic luxuries that we have in life, we are still prone to a lot more lifestyle disease. And one of the topmost is heart, right? So how do we first identify that we are having this issue, and what is the kind of plan that we should have to overcome this challenge?
Yeah. So here I come back to type of heart disease. See, if a family has a genetic lineage towards a valve problem in the heart, there are two main valves. So some of the families are born with it. So you know that the age of 60, 65, according to your lifestyle, or maybe earlier, your valves are going to start closing, which means you need a valve replacement to continue your life with a healthier lifestyle. So if you already know that, you need to keep watching that. Right?
You mean to say if generations of your family members have heart issue, we should keep a watch?
Yeah. And this type of heart issue, which is a mechanical problem in the heart, which can worsen as time goes. And hence, sometime they may need this valve replacement. It is like changing the valve in your pipe in the house. Yeah. After that, their life is beautiful. It comes back to normal. So they cannot do much but lead a good lifestyle. Every heart disease, the main thing is vegetables, fruits, whole cereals, which is common, regular lifestyle, right? Whether it's red rice or wheat or whatever, bajra, tenne, all of this, plus less oil, plus cook at home, laugh, enjoy, dance, play, everything. People have forgotten. We need a laughing club for people to laugh. Just think about it. Where are we here? Come on. Why don't we laugh? I remember my grandfather used to sit with us. We were about 20, 30 of us sitting there. He will cut two pieces of fruit and give to each one of them. The youngest one will run around giving the fruit. And we laugh and laugh for the jokes that each one says. Do we ever do these things? You may be virtually connecting with everybody. Are you laughing? Are you jumping? Are you skipping? Are you, you know, we need to do these things. It's okay, COVID, so what? Why can't you do it virtually? Sitting with Soundarya here, I can jump and dance and laugh, isn't it? Why not? Right? So that is very, very important. The social aspect to de-stress. Like you may be thinking you have the highest problem that day, but you know, your granddad or your an uncle who's been with you is, hey, I've seen 20 times that. What's this big deal you're talking about?
Yes, in fact, they would have seen much more problems where they wouldn't have had these easier way out. They would have had a tougher way out, but they have still overcome all of that.
Exactly. So the mental grit was far better. Nobody walked into the sea saying that my exam I did was bad, so bye-bye. What is this? How many failures? Everybody who does CA knows that there are a lot of this thing, right? So stress, I think I've totally digressed from the question. The other type of heart disease is, it's called decompensated heart disease. That means through time, due to my lifestyle, my heart has started pumping slowly or less. So what happens? There is water around my body, even around my heart, a little bit. Because the heart is not able to compensate to the work that I need to do with the body. These are the people who should be very, very stringent. Work with their doctor, dietitian, look at the amount of fluids they take, watch their sodium, don't overactivity. All of that is only for this group, which is a decompensated heart disease. Okay? This happens when you have spoiled yourself so much. But when we talk about a block, or when we talk about all of this, this can be assessed through, through your lipid profile. So if you know your triglyceride is going up automatically, your bad cholesterol, the LDL and VLDL is going up. If these two go up, automatically your clots in the body can go up. If the clot is in my little finger in the little tip, I mean, they might not even know. But if the clot is a bigger one and somewhere it starts moving, it can create havoc. Right? So, heart attack, this word has multiple meanings. It could be because a particular clot went into a bigger vessel, which, you know, said the heart, hey, I'm choking. It's like a pump. It will scream to say, hey, I'm not able to pump water. So like that, your heart is saying, hey, I'm not able to do, and hence it goes into an attack. That is one. Second could be stress, as we spoke about. Third could be decompensated disease. Fourth could be uncontrolled diabetes, which is leading to heart disease. So there are various, various types, and each one need to be handled differently.
So is there like a for a lame person, right, who doesn't have any issues or who is working 8 hours a day or 12 hours a day, right? Is that like a diet plan that you could suggest?
Very, very simple. Cook from home first. Second, use less oil, the 15 ml I told you. Third, breakfast, have a cup of fruits and have reduce the quantity of breakfast so that you don't put on weight. Because at least in the urban cities, we find people are putting a lot of weight in the abdominal area. Abdominal area fat is directly related to non-communicable diseases, out of which heart disease is one. Okay, so reduce your, don't eat 5 idlis, 4 idlis, 3 dosas like that. Have a cup of fruit. If you're the person who's stressed out, you know, fruit should not be eaten with cooked food. Please eat your fruit after half an hour, have your breakfast. No problem. You will still eat less. Absolutely no problem. So 2 idlis, 2 dosas, a cup of, I'm giving an average, okay, because most people are overweight. If somebody is underweight, please, we need to change this. This is for an average group.
I'm sure there is customization possible for every diet plan, but generally, this is what you're suggesting.
Yeah. So fruit, a grain with a little bit of chutney, if possible, sambar. If you're diabetic, 100% have a protein there. It can be sundal, it can be sprouts, it can be egg, whatever, sambar. Dip your idli in sambar, more sambar than idli. That's the idea. Okay. Then lunch and dinner, 1 cup of rice is equal to 2 rotis. Okay. 1 cup, 200 ml cooked rice is equal to 2 full cups.
Mm-hmm.
So that is your grain portion, 1 cup. Add double the portion of vegetable.
Okay.
Have equal quantity of protein, dal. Okay. Or egg, or fish, or chicken. Fish, chicken should be cooked, grilled, less oil, within the 15 ml per day, per person.
Okay, okay.
So that way. And then curd.
Right.
Half cup curd. So yeah. Your lunch and dinner are ditto.
Okay.
What people do? No vegetable, no protein at dinner.
So there are people who do grain. Oats only, fruit only. And there are diets, right? Okay.
It's not sustainable. They'll follow it for a short while. Then it's all gone.
Guilty. I'm guilty. I think I have tried GM diet and scapegoat has been my husband. I've tried a couple of more, some motor related, something else. So I have tried and tested a lot of these things, but eventually, I think what I figured out is you eat, like you said, right? Those diet plans that you said almost follow similar and do a lot of workout. I think that's...
See.
Yeah.
Yeah. 45 minutes exercise minimum every day. And then after that, like you and I are sitting for 1 hour. After that, get up and turn around 2 times, 3 times and sit back. Or if possible, walk around and come back. Just get a half a cup of water and sit up. So that little exercise, what are you doing the rest? 8 hours you're sleeping, 1 hour you're exercising, 9 hours gone. What are you doing the rest of the hours is a question we need to answer. You cannot be totally sedentary, right? So that is also important.
Thank you so much. I think we had a great conversation where we understood the importance of diet. Every or nutrition or sattunavu is important for our diet. Adumato illama stress, and we have to laugh. I think we have forgotten how to laugh in the last 2 years staying at home. Thanks for reminding us, and definitely I'm sure a lot of people will listen to this, because enna expensive ah neenga vandu solla poringa appdinu yosichathukku appuram இவ்வளவு சிம்பிளான ஒரு டெக்னிக் மேம் சொல்லியிருக்காங்க, விச் இஸ் லாஃபிங், ரைட்? ஐ திங்க் வென் வி லாஃப் அவர் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் இஸ் ரெடியூஸ், அண்ட் அதுவே ஒரு பெரிய மருந்து ஃபார் அவர் ஹார்ட். ஸோ டுவர்ட்ஸ் தி ஹெல்தி ஹார்ட், தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் ஃபார் ஜாயினிங் அஸ் டுடே டாக்டர் தாரிணி, அண்ட் இட் வாஸ் வெரி
இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். ஐ ஜஸ்ட் ஹேவ் 2 points. கேன் ஐ ஆட் 2 points இஃப் யூ டோன்ட் மைண்ட்? ஒன் இஸ், இஃப் யூ ஃபீல் லைக் கிரைங், கிரை, நதிங் இஸ் ரைட். கோ டு தி டாய்லெட் அண்ட் கிரை இஃப் யூ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் யுவர் கலீக்ஸ் டு see. If you're at home, please make everybody know that you're crying. It's not wrong. It's not wrong. It's good for every person in the family to know you were hurt and that you were hurt so badly that you're crying. Crying is not wrong. It's a very good way of de-stressing. Okay? Second, next time you go to buy provisions, try to pick up at least that 5 kilos in your hand and not put it into that cart and wheel it into your cart. Because that is resistance exercise. Very simple. You said that your parents walked around, brought back the vegetables, went in public buses, walked. So for them, activity was part of life. Resistance exercise was part of life. They didn't have to take out 45 minutes out of that. So please carry your stuff around. Move around with it. Don't get these rolling carts unless it's, you know, a monthly thing. Okay, yeah. Your back may not hold it. That's fine. But in that, at least pick up something and take it while you go down so that you're carrying it. You don't need to do that separate exercise, which never happens. Yeah. Good luck.
Actually, I have told my kids. Sometimes in the rice put 5 kg or 10 kg, right? Sometimes I tell them carry that 5 kg